It, you know, you had that very strong,
yeah. What was going on with all of that? Where did that all come from? The narrative for that was interesting.
That was a bit cheesy, let's say. Okay.
Well, you know, you make it. I just hang out and play it.
That's
so,
okay. That was fun for that purpose. But now, so we created four families: the pro racer, the street racer, off road, and freestyle, where you will find basically what you love. If you're more in that kind of playstyle, if you're, you know, looking for the perfect line and really want to have the beat the extra milliseconds, you're not going to go for the pro racer. Maybe the next day you want to do free drive and just enjoy the ride. It's okay. So everything in the game now is open, and the progression lets you do whatever you want inside of the game. So we have tons of disciplines with different kind of vehicles to really fit what you want to play today. And if it's different tomorrow, it's okay. You will have everything else, you know?
Well, looking at this gameplay footage, this looks like it would be insane in VR. Are you guys going to do something with VR as well?
No, right now we are focusing on dealing.
That would be so crazy. That would be the game, you know? That would be like
so
one of the
cool, though.
Did you see that?
Yeah, I saw that. Tell me what's going on. You're like, you're flying, you're driving into the water, you have a water vehicle.
Because
then you become a flight, then you become a plane.
And is it cool?
That's amazing.
Look
this
back
is
at
exactly
me.
Why we did
but,
it.
But did it start out that way? Did you guys have four distinct versions, ways of playing the game? Or did you guys just say, okay, you're going to instantly go from a car to a boat, from a boat to a plane?
No, actually what we created first are the different kind of vehicles. So we created the bikes, the cars, the planes, the boats, and really wanted to have different kind of play styles. So you have power boats that go very fast in gycline. If you want to take a turn, good luck.
Sure.
And then we have different kind of boats that are very good at doing turns. And we created all those kind of different kind of vehicles. And then we said to the world builders, the level designers, have fun. Those are your toys. Create the perfect world for that.
Amazing.
And so they created crazy kind of missions where you have to switch from one type of vehicle to the other, just like that, because that's going to be the perfect line for you and reach the perfect score. And this is where the magic happens.
There definitely is a lot of magic going on. Gosh, it's so cool. I'm so happy you guys decided to go with that.
Yeah.
It's unique. I don't think I've ever really seen that before.
And you know, everything is coming from the community, actually. We, you know, on the Q1, we had like, I think, 12 million players. We reached that huge number for our first game, you know, new license. And the players are really happy and still very active in the game right now. And they wanted to have new kind of stuff like that. So we asked them, said, what do you want? So they ask for the world and whatnot and everything else, and say, okay, we'll pick the thing that really makes sense for you guys and that we can deliver with high quality. And right now, for example, the motocross, it's playable right now at Gamescom.
Oh,
that's
cool.
Part of the three disciplines that we are revealing here at Gamescom. We have the motocross, we have the drift, and we have the Alpha Grand Prix, kind of a super high-speed vehicle. Yeah.
Yeah, what is your favorite one off the top of your head? You probably love them all. You probably love driving them all. But what is your favorite one?
My favorite Alpha Grand Prix is crazy. Because we created this kind of circuit that really feels natural with this kind of vehicle. But you can also take the vehicle and go off-road. You can do whatever you want. So imagine that you have this kind of super crazy vehicle and going fast inside of the streets of New York.
Yeah.
You can do that. And so you have the sound of that huge vehicle going at speed of 300 kilometers inside of the street of New York.
That's awesome.
It's crazy.
That's awesome.
It's really crazy.
I would bump into all the buildings.
Yeah. Is it being optimized for the X1, 1X or what? X1.
We're going to be everywhere.
Everywhere.
X1X, X1S, X1.
There's so many things. Yeah. So many things.
PS4, PS Pro, and we're going to be also on PC, obviously. Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's great.
And it's getting out on March the 16th. So 2018, obviously. We're going to have a lot of beta phases. So, you know, we love the community, so we want to have the feedback from the community very early on. So we're going to announce the details quite early on.
Great.
The sign-ups are already ready, open, and we have quite a lot of people knocking at the doors right now. So we're just like, okay, hold on, we are finishing it.
I remember in the last one, you could drive around in South Beach. Right?
Yeah.
I'm from South Beach.
Okay.
Miami.
Yeah.
That's why I'm so good looking. But are we going back to the same locations? Or are we going to explore new places? Is it new parts of the country that we haven't seen before in the game?
So, you know, we have some star players from Ubisoft that know the game so well. Like,
sure.
They are crazy, those guys.
Yeah, they just know every little part.
That kind of details, and you pick it out, and I didn't even know myself, but it's okay. And they play the game. They play the crew too, and they are just like, I can't recognize the world.
Really? I mean, what do you mean? Why?
Because we changed everything.
You've changed so much.
All the assets are different. We created new environments, new feelings, etc. So some
why?
Some iconic places are still there because it's the US.
Right.
That makes sense. Right. But for some other, we took the freedom to recreate something that makes more sense for the fun. You know, different kind of vehicles.
Do you think that does that add more realism to the gamer?
I think it's more arcade-y, basically.
Okay.
And that's really what the players wanted. They really felt that they don't want to have too much simulation kind of game inside of the crew. There are other games that are doing that, and they are
great
at that. But our players, they prefer arcade games. They want something easy to handle. That's the Alpha Grand Prix that we see right now. It's kind of a crazy one-seat.
See, in VR, that right there would be wild.
I would get nauseous.
That, of course.
This game makes you think very differently about a race. Because you're like, this corner always messes me up. I can go over it with an airplane. And you could just switch like that.
Yeah. And that's the beauty. This is where basically the players start to create their own story. We have players switching vehicles in a ways that we said, okay, why are they thinking like that? And they create crazy stunts and make super high score that are recorded and then shared with the community to try to beat that score. And then you see that and it's just like, they are just crazy. And this is what we are waiting for the beta phases, to see how the players will take all those stories and create their own stories.
Isn't the airplane always going to be the fastest way?
No, actually we have an RPG system behind the game. So everything that you do in the game helps you progress. You earn new parts, you equip them on your vehicles, and you can make them faster or, you know, have